the end of my using lasted 10 years. And in that 10 years, I was just constantly asking, why have I got EPC? Why have I got a DVT? Why have I got leg ulcers? Why have I got abscess scars? Why am I divorced? Why am I denied access to my children? Why am I labelled? Why am I stigmatised? Why am I ostracised? Why am I abandoned? Why am I rejected? Why am I in prison? Why do I keep getting arrested? Why am I homeless? Why can't I stop using? Just constants. Why? Lay on prison beds, the length of breath of this country. Sat in rehabs, the length of breath of this country. Constantly asking why. And it was only when I stopped and started to ask how. How can I stop?
Now, a lot of people think that prison is a deterrent for offenders. But what I've discovered in the course of these couple of days is that when people are absolute slaves to their addiction to the point that they'd be prepared to lose their legs in order to keep satisfying that craving, prison's actually not much more than the health camp, as one put it to me. Because they go in there, get themselves cleaned up, they're still on drugs while they're in there, or they're perhaps on drugs and methadone. They get themselves fit and then they're back out and doing the same thing all over again. I hope people don't overstate the deterrent effect of prison.
Used heroin and crack for 20 years and also spent, probably out of the 20 years I used heroin and crack, probably spent 7 years in jail. Prison, I hated prison. I hated it. When I came into Acorn, I sort of like realised that me taking drugs equaled me going into prison, really. You know, that was a simple equation that Acorn really helped me to establish in my heart. I remember lying in bed when I was using and being in touch with this thing. I didn't quite know what it was. It was very confusing at the time. And I sort of recognised what it was, and it was a yearning for to be able to just do what I said I'm going to do.
My name's Andrew. As a result and a consequence of my addiction, served two large prison sentences for a number of armed robberies. Whilst in prison in custody on my second sentence, I decided that enough was enough and I didn't want to leave that life anymore. A member of staff from Acorn Treatment who came in, introduced himself, told me about his story and about, you know, how he turned his life around. He sold me the idea of treatment. You know, he gave me this this plan how I could turn my life around and how I could change things. You know, this guy stuck to every appointment, kept to his word, you know, and that's where the trust was built. So he agreed to go into treatment. I was picked up from the gate. If it hadn't have been, I probably would have never have made it here. You know, they made sure that I got to the treatment centre safe. I was put in a house, you know, with other people that I could relate to who were embarking on this journey that I was just about to start.
So I'd got a phone call from one of Andrew's relatives, and I was working in the prison, so I made my way straight over to see him. He was there, he was receptive, and I took that back to Acorn, because that's what we do. I said, there's a lad here, he's ready to roll. So we pretty much fast-tracked it. We dotted the I's, crossed the T's. We picked him up from the gate, and we took him straight into treatment. And the rest is history, really. Here he is, sat here, clean, sober, enjoying life beyond his wildest dreams. So that's what it's all about, innit?
My name's John Richmond. I'm a substance misuse specialist. Our company, Delphi Medical, supplies medical expertise to the substance misuse field in North Lancashire and in a number of prisons in Staffordshire, Rochdale and in North Lancashire. We've just started a contract in HMP Buckley Hall, and RAMP also started to be delivered by Acorn Treatment there. Again, it's a very well attended course. The patients that I know that are at it have said that they really think it's exciting and worthwhile, and we have high hopes for the future.
Well, I was in prison for many years, you know, I think in total about 7 to 8 years in prison. What happened was, on each occasion, was I'd be using shortly after getting out, and that happened every single time I come out of prison. When I came to Acorn, I got
exactly what I needed was a proper treatment from people who cared. You know, right through the staff care, the right through the staff have been there, right through the staff know exactly how you feel and what to do and how to give you the help and support to get you through. I've never known anything like it in my life, to be quite honest.
People like myself needed rehab. It's always the bad news to try and white knuckle it, as I tried it and it didn't work. I was lucky enough to go to the Priory, but some people in Manchester aren't lucky enough to go to the Priory. And this is why Acorn come into their own, because they look after the most socially deprived people that they possibly can.
I was committing offences every day. I was a prolific offender at the time, which was called the PADS team in Wimbledon. I had two officers, Simon and Brian. They took me to all my appointments. They took me to get my scripts. They took me to court. They'd come to my house twice a week. Because basically I was just committing offences every day. I ended up asking for help, went into a therapeutic community, wasn't for me. You know, it served a purpose, but it just wasn't for me. Cleaning toilets was not going to cut it for me. So I ended up getting kicked out of there, like I'd done everywhere else I ever went. So I ended up coming to Acorn as a last resort, because I didn't want to go back to my home estate, which is Wythenshaw. And I came in, you know. I met people who had used like me and who'd been in the same places as me. I'd seen a few of them in the system, in prison, in different prisons. I knew people from the estate who used like me, like James. So that kept me there.
The Navigate Prolific Offender team, and we work with people who've got a big history of crime and drug or alcohol abuse. And this facility will certainly help them massively.
Hello, my name's Darren. I'm a 25-year heroin and crack user. I was a prolific shoplifter. 2004, I was on the front page of the Manchester Evening News, the Advertiser, the Metro, all of the papers, as Manchester's most prolific shoplifter. I was in and out of jail. I'd done about 10 years behind the door in prison, and now I'm a recovering addict, nearly 5 years abstinent, and I help spotlight clients. I work with PPO clients, and they kind of gravitate towards me because, you know, I'm not out of unit. You know, I haven't read it from a book. I've been there, and it seems to work. You know, I've got people into rehab, and they've got their lights. The lights have come back on for them as well, and now they're managing to live a good life. You know, the families are back in their lives, and when one person recovers, the whole family recover.
Drugs have led me to a life of crime, being arrested, being sent in prison. I've lost everything. I got disowned. Coming into Acorn, it's giving me my life back, as well as giving me my life back. You know, I've finally got my family, and it's only through Acorn that I've been able to get all this, and my parents get their son back, which I'm really, really happy about.
It's that simple for me. Sometimes it's like, you know, this person who's in front of me, whose life's obviously destroyed because of addiction, it's like sometimes I look past that person and I see the children, I see the families, I see all the potential victims of crime. And that it's more than that, just that person in front of you. It's just massive. You know, you help one addict, and the knock-on effect to everyone else is just off the scale. It's unmeasurable, and that's why, you know, I help people.
We got a couple of really, you know, guys with big offending backgrounds doing well and wanting to put something back in to the community they came from, and that really was the start, 18 months ago, that our foundation of actually putting the support networks in place and basically giving people a sense of hope.
For me, the proof is in the pudding. I was around people who'd been where I'd been, done what I'd done, and they were the ones that helped me through, you know, and I'm trying to do that for other people now, to help other people.
It's the biggest advert you can have. You know, we can go around and spread the message and say, oh, by the way, you know, such and such has done well, but when you've got somebody physically in the community, it's really, really powerful.
This is part of the deal, you know, I get clean and I go out and help others. And that's what we all do in this establishment. We get clean and we help others.
My name's Ian Wardle. I'm the Chief Executive of Lifeline. We're fortunate enough to be providing the new recovery service in the city of Manchester with our new partners, Acorn, who will be providing the ramp service. And so we're both on the threshold of an exciting new set of developments.
If we can succeed in getting people back into useful work and useful lives, then it has to be of a benefit to everybody, the whole community.
I am Judge Foster, QC. I sit at Minchell Street Crown Court in Manchester. I have a close knowledge of the consequence of drugs in the devastation of lives and the commission of crime. I also act as the liaison probation judge and therefore deal with the rehabilitative processes both in a custodial and a community setting. Much of that work is aimed at drink or drug reduction or abstinence. There are a variety of approaches. Acorn promotes abstinence. It is a valuable program and regime, and it works. That is why I am always pleased to see the probation using the services of Acorn in appropriate circumstances.
Because Acorn helped me, just by default, they've helped thousands of people, and it's just, that just blows me away.
No, I'm no longer a burden on society. No, I feel like I give back. And I hope, you know, in my role that I'm able to offer people the same hope and inspiration that I got from those members of staff who changed my life. You know, not only my life, but, you know, the lives of the people who are around me. So it's by far the best thing and the best decision I ever made in my life.
I'm Andrew Stunnell, I'm the MP for Hazelgrove in Stockport. Obviously Acorn have got a great record right across the northwest, and it's good to see them with a new enterprise starting here in Stockport, which is going to help them, help the community, and help many of the people who will be working here in the future. So I wish them well in the project.
My name's Tom Woodcock, I'm Strategic Director with Lancashire DAT, and we've been working with Acorn for the last few years. They're part of our Inspire partnership in East Lancashire, and I know from service users who've been through the RAMP programme how effective it's been. So I'm a big fan, and I wish the organisation all the best in the future.
Now my life is going to help other people. I get up in the morning, I go to work, I've got my children in my life.
Yeah, I've just got a job, yeah, my first job ever. The only job I've ever had was in the kitchens and strangeways. So besides that, this is my first job, so I'm made up.
They really gave me the opportunity to look at my life and gave me the chance to change.
But the thing that got me when I came here was the people.
I seen someone that I've been in strange ways with.
And I knew that he used like me, so in the end I ended up coming in here myself.
They'd been where I'd been and they understood.
The biggest thing for me was that these were people in recovery themselves. I got this air of these people being genuine and actually understanding, you know, where I'd been.
They understood. And that was the main thing, that they understood where I was at.
4 years, 16 days clean today.
I'm 9 years clean. I've got a good job as a counsellor. But most importantly, I feel okay inside.
I work in a job. I wouldn't even call it a job. It's a vocation to me. I love this. Love it.
There's nothing like helping the next man. There's no feeling like it.
Proper empowering.
Biggest, most important thing for me is that I feel fulfilled.
What I've got in my life, gorgeous girlfriend, got two gorgeous kids, got a lovely home. There's no narrative for what I've got. There just isn't.
So I'm 30 years old next week. I've been sentenced to a total of 10 and a half years. I've served seven. And I've been clean for the other three.
I'm nearly 8 years clean and sober. Since I come into Acorn, I've not committed one crime. I panic if I've not got tax on my car.
And now I'm a recovering addict, nearly 5 years abstinent.
Employed, crime-free.
I got clean, which is just over 4 years ago.
I've trained as a therapist. I'm a drugs and alcohol practitioner, and now I'm back in college doing a teacher qualification, which, you know, if it wasn't for coming in Acorn and seeing people who I knew had used like me, seeing them getting on with their lives, it just had a massive, massive, massive effect on my life.
What goes on at a prison landing is just miles away from that now, miles away from that. It's a far cry from listening to a cell door bang.